Okay, traders, good morning and welcome to this live intraday strategy webinar on SB Trade Desk. Today is Thursday, April 23rd. Mike Boutros with you on the horn, guys. We're about to get the release of initial jobless claims for the US. We're looking for a print of 4.5 million, comes out at 4.42 million. So right in line with expectations. That comes off a previous week of 5.3 million, looks like. So not too much worse than expected. Great to be with you guys this morning. Just wanted to get that print out to you as soon as possible. Good morning, Iman, Jay, Peter, Pete, Rizwan, Ted. Great to see everyone here in the room. Hey, DJ, great to see you, sir. So lots to discuss. DXY is testing resistance essentially right here. We'll talk about that. Euro, dollar yen still holding the weekly opening range. Dollar CAD showing some strength on CAD. Dollar CAD lower as crude kind of finds its legs again. Gold, critical resistance. Got the SPX at downslope resistance. Sterling, Kiwi, Aussie, and dollar Swiss. Any other trade setups or questions, guys, as always, feel free to throw them on the message board at any time. Let's jump right in. So with that print follows a third pretty dark week for weekly jobless claims. Here's DXY as it stands on the weekly chart. We've been following this for a while. The slope still in focus here on today's, this weekly close has already been tested essentially. So we're looking to see if whether we're going to get exhaustion here or not. There's not much to look at still, unfortunately, on the DXY chart. Here's what it looks like, or on the weekly at least, here's what it looks like on the intraday and the daily. So the only thing I want to point out here is this long-standing 786. It's a retracement we've been following from the high that we made back in 2017. You know, hasn't really given us much play, so that's there to consider. Only thing I want to highlight here is momentum flatlining below 60, showing possible exhaustion for the near-term uptrend. Here's what it looks like on the intraday. Okay, we've been following this pitchfork since last week. We had a 38.2 gradient on here as far as the slope, which caught these highs, but I brought it back to the 50 or the 25% line of the broader pitchfork resistance. And here we are again at that 50. This is just of the recent drop from March. The big level I would have wanted to see on a dollar stretch and failure was up here. Okay, this is the 618. It converges on slope basically early next week, with the 100% off the low, just higher. Beautiful range. You guys all know it's my favorite Fibonacci confluence, 100 off the low, 618 off the high, big zone. I don't know if I'm inclined to do anything on this, okay? We're looking for a turn, either here, basically where we are right now on that weekly slope, or with another test higher, would take you into this key zone. So for DXY, in and of itself, you know, it's an uptrend, but you're at near-term resistance. It's not a strong conviction trade. You also have to keep in mind that, guys, the objective monthly opening range is right here. So it's littered with possible stretch reversals, possible key resistance zones just higher. Don't really have much to do on this. Unfortunately, Euro basically is in the same boat, a little bit clearer in my opinion, but long story short, the game plan here, it's either a stretch back into this key zone of resistance or a break below slope support, ideally yesterday's low, to validate the reversal and push into 99. So either we stretch here, we look for failure, or if this breaks, you look to sell rallies down towards this key support. But right here is a pivotal juncture for DXY. All the April debacle and all the April volatility, and DXY has done nothing but this. Okay, know where the trade is, know where to look. Unfortunately, right now, this is kind of on standstill. Next up on tap, that's a quick look at DXY. Number two, here's Euro, not much better, but also a quick reminder of where Euro is on the weekly charts. Again, still holding that swing low that we made in late January of 2016. Swing low that we made earlier this year in February. You saw pivots on both sides. That's still, you know, the lateral support on a weekly basis, key support, the March 2017 high week close, right here. It was the high week close for this range, not the yearly high week close, but you get the picture. Euro on the daily chart looks like this. The big zone of support here, not too distant from what DXY is doing, is just lower at the low day close for the year. It's the day that we registered the swing low in price, March 23rd. The close was 107.26 on a break of 107.77. I told you guys that was pretty big. This was the next major level you'd look for an exhaustion. I'm not quite sure what to do with this. My snap judgment, kind of shotgun call, would be to fade this move. It is an attempted break of the monthly opening range low. So important fact, we should see acceleration here, not kind of this pullback. So it's a tough play, guys. It's not a clear cut play. Discuss ESF, please. Chip, you talking about SPX futures? We'll definitely take a look. I got you, Chip. Good seeing the room, sir. So for Euro, again, momentum holding just above 40. Like you're flirting with an area of which could be possible exhaustion, but there's not much conviction there yet. Here's what the intraday chart looks like, and here's what we've been following for Euro. This is what it looked like back on the 21st. I threw this slope on there, guys, telling you that there is no way too early rely on this slope, but I wanted to see if you were going to get a hold. Even when these slopes don't hold, and you tack on a pitchfork, it still highlighted the same zone. And as soon as you got that break, look what happened. Acceleration, right? Instant resistance, move lower. So if this is a break of the weekly opening range, you should be looking for a Thursday, Friday low. It's Thursday, but certainly the low would have been really sweet if we would have gotten a 107.26 clip. So not positioned in this yet. If we get a drawdown in US trade today, look for reaction down there at 107.26. Dependent on where we are in time, okay, immediately bearish validation is right here with the weekly open. That's 108.63. If we make the drawdown into the low day close, you'll want to bring that down to 108.31. That's 618. Again, a really decent pivot in price. The upper slope will be there about close of the week, start of next week. So you get the picture. Again, DXY and Euro, both one of those levels where you could see it stretch a little bit lower. You want to see it probe a little bit lower, but it's just not there right now. I'm short about 108.73. Not bad. Eman, cut half at 107.61. Excellent. Excellent. If broken at 107.26, what's the next target? So if 107.26 gives out, I have a soft target at just the swing lows for the year. That's 106.35. There's nothing in between. If you tack on a retracement, a 786 comes. Well, let me just show it to you. Just a little bit lower, like right there. But a look in lateral for support, I mean, there's not much there. So I've put a little bit more stock in the low day close at 107.26. If that gives back or gives out rather, I really there wouldn't be much to hold this thing up beyond the yearly lows. Eman, does that make sense? Or that was for Rizwan. Excuse me, does that make sense? So interesting price action. Rizwan says yes. All right, right on. Interesting price action in Euro and DXY. You know, a lot of times we like to look at the both of those in congruence, right? Obviously, 60% of that index is weighted Euro. But it's a precarious spot here. It's a precarious spot. I'm still on the lookout for an exhaustion low. If you're holding shorts, your next big level is 107.26. Look for a reaction there if reached. All right. Also, I want to remind everyone of the Trader Summit. I don't know if you guys saw the tweet that Jamie sent out. He'll be speaking at that summit next week. Attendance is free, so definitely encourage you guys to join him for that. Next up on tap, dollar yen. So here's what we look like on dollar yen last night. Okay, the weekly opening range was intact, just below down slope resistance. So We've been following this one for a while. Longer term, let me just show you real quick, end of the week. Here's where dollar yen's trading broadly speaking. This was the big resistance zone, objective yearly open last week, kind of continued to hold right below that. You're still right slap in the middle of the yearly range. So there's not much on the weekly chart to give you guidance. For me, it's been all about the intraday plays here. Here's dollar yen on the daily chart. Really clean monthly opening range. Here's your monthly open. You set a low, you set a high within the first couple of 7 days of trade. You tested the low again last week, that held. This week has just been a clear cut range. Now the broader focus for us has been to look for exhaustion high. This is key resistance, near-term bearish inval, and a break below the monthly opening range lows would put you right on track for another move on 106. I'm still thinking that's sort of the play. Here's what we're looking at. Dollar yen, first of all, daily chart, momentum. And this is the thing that's kind of irking me across the majors, guys. A lot of these trade setups, the daily momentum, the RSI reading, it's just flatlining, right? And that's where you want to be very nimble. In, out, in, out. You don't want to sit in a trade and expect to see the whole vertical move. There's no momentum behind it. Right. And this is certainly at this point, specifically with the lack of economic data, it's really a kind of a headline driven market. So we look to these ranges with a lot more intent, a lot more vigor, right? Because we want to see those breaks give us some clear directional biases. Here's what the intraday chart looks like. You're basically testing some support levels right now that you'd want to focus on. That slope resistance continued to hold. Here's where we were last night. Tested it again, tested again. Here's a move. I'm not putting too much stock in this upslope, guys. We've had to adjust this a couple of times, as you might have noticed. The focus is on the weekly opening range right here. So if we break sub 107.31, right, you're basically looking for a test of the monthly opening range low at 106.90. That breaks, we're right on track, right? 106.42 and 106 being the key zone, specifically 106.05 into 106.10, the 2019 low day close. But it's all about this is sort of a clean opening range trade for me. If you get the break, it's going to be tough to try to jump back in, but the focus would take you back towards those 106.90 and 106.40 handle. Short below 107.40, what should be the stop? So Rizwan, remember how we trade these breaks, man. You don't want to actually sell the break, right? If it does break, you would need some sort of rebound recovery for a reversal test of resistance. Your short would be against that swing high. Ideally, if you're holding something, Rizwan, or you jumped into this already, your stop is against the session high. But you don't want to sell down here. It's just not a very good risk reward, right? If it breaks, that gives you the validation and bias that doesn't necessarily trigger a position. Don't misunderstand what I'm saying, right? When we look for the weekly opening range breaks, that just gives you directional bias. That's not when you trigger the trade. If you're not already in it, then you'd need to wait for the retest and failure to jump back in. Make sense? Yep. All right. He says, thanks. I'll shorten the retest. Yeah. Okay. Any other questions on dollar yen? The abomination taking up some attention today, but the levels look clean. And the funny part is you're basically looking for a break of like Friday's range, the Thursday, Friday range of last week. All of this has still been within the confines of that singular range. All right. Dollar CAD, number four. Here was what it looks like. So here's what it looked like last night. Let me do that first. A breakout of downtrend resistance last week shifted the focus higher. We were looking for exhaustion since last week at one of these two levels. Now, I had labeled this as the bearish inval, right? We broke higher. It ran to 43.61, the 50% retrace and pulled back. It was holding this support zone or this support slope, 25% line yesterday. So basically what you're looking for is, does this bounce validate a further rally? The major key resistance zone is right here in dollar CAD. I'm of the mindset that this is kind of like gonna be the fake out, You know, we've been favoring shorts for a while. You guys know earlier in the month, this breakout did shift the focus higher. Even on yesterday's rebound, I thought you'd go for another retest of a new high before this thing turns out. At the end of the day, it's the pullback. This is what matters. Upslope support. You have the objective April open just lower at 40.58. That's your key support. Look for a reaction there. Now, if we break lower, right, the 618 of the advance comes in right at the weekly open. The weekly open registered at 40.15. 618's at 40.11. So really love the levels, but certainly, you know, I didn't catch this. Another one, a lot of missed trades this week. I didn't catch this on the sort of failure here. Was looking for at least another retest of the median line. If not, stop against this high. Look for a reaction here at the end of the day. One thing I want to say about dollar CAD, guys, this thing has been taking on a lot of pump start fakes, right? So don't be quick to jump on the bandwagon unless you have decent positioning on it. After the abomination, another pair that hates me is gold. Can you take a look, Gary? What is this dollar CAD? Gold's on the list right next, sir. I got you. Gold's at critical resistance, Gary. Whatever you do, man, 1740s, 1730s, not even there, is absolutely critical. Absolutely critical. 618 from where, i.e., 4011. Don't know how it's calculated. Rizwan, which one? This one? It's the 618 of the near-term rally. Right off the lows. So this is like the most operable 618 we should be focused on right now, on this pullback. And the reason I want to highlight that is because slope support comes in ahead. So you would think to yourself, oh, this broke upslope support. We're looking lower. Don't get faked out, because the weekly open, when it converges on key fib ratios like that, can be pretty wicked. You have even a long wick from this massive day back on the 20th. Look where it dropped. Pretty close to that 40 level, huh? So, you know, that's the level that would mark resumption. And certainly we've been favoring broadly the broader short side of dollar CAD, but it's been tough because you get these false starts and absolute collapses. Breaks lower, you think you're seeing resumption, then a quick recovery, right? You got to clear out some of these weak hands. Initial focus right now heading to the US trade session, the test of slope support, the test of the monthly open. Look for reaction here. If it rebounds, I'd want to see failure again ahead of Friday's high, again of that 41.65. And then if it breaks that 40.11, you're looking for resumption. You're looking for that 38 handle, 37.90 region. That's the 2017 high. It's a 50% of just the yearly range. Really nice spot. But that might be a little bit too far ahead right now. The focus right now is whether we get, and if we get, some sort of reaction down here. Rizwan says, okay, thanks, sir, for such a nice analysis. Hey, you're more than welcome, Rizwan. Cheers, mate. More than welcome. And remember, they're not my levels, guys. I'm just trying to help you find them. It's the market's levels. All right, gold. Who was asking about that? Gary, here's what's going on with gold, man. Listen, this one is one of those things where you need to really be focused on what's happening in the longer-term picture. Click on the previous update. A quick reminder, guys, I alternate each update with the accompanying weekly and daily charts. So if you don't see them, they're always one click away. Here's what we were looking at. This weekly chart, you know, we've looked at, so I was saying in the webinar on Tuesday, I think, for like literally years. Here's gold on the weekly. The level in focus was 1733. It's the 786 retracement of the entire decline off the record 2011 high. I was at, remember, just shy of $2,000, 1920. The entire decline, 786 is right there, 1733. Alongside that, a multi-year uptrend slope. Here's the pitchfork off the 2013-2015 lows, lower pitchfork support. Sliding parallel resistance, resistance, resistance. We had a pivot break, a little bit messy this year, obviously on account of everything that we've seen, but look where we are. All right, now, we've been here before, right? We've been here before, just last week, point in fact, but look where we closed last week. We registered high at 1747. We closed 1683, below that slope again. So, do you want to believe this? I'm not touching it. If you put a pistol to my head right now, not a trade recommendation, but just to put a pistol to my head, I'd say this thing is a fade because you're going to find another exhaustion here. If we break last week's high, and specifically it's on a daily close basis, you're looking for 1795, you're looking for 1856, the high we close, the record high we close. But my point is uptrend resistance. Remember what I always tell you guys, a breach of uptrend resistance can oftentimes be the sharpest part of the rally. A break of downtrend support can often be the steepest part of the drop. My point is, if this is going to break here and if it breaches, it should be fast, man. It shouldn't be a slow, I'm just going to, mark a daily, weekly close here and then mutter higher. No, we should see acceleration if we get through this. So, all things held constant, you're at risk. This is going to be the third reference point in weekly divergence into fresh highs and price action as the oscillator makes lower highs. If we're going to get exhaustion, guys, this is the zone to look for. Okay, that's the weekly chart from 1,000 feet up. Here's gold on the daily. Okay, there's that 786 retracement, 1733. The high day close for this year comes in at 1726. And that's what I noted yesterday in the update. That's the zone we need to clear for us to try to make another run at the highs. Okay, so the immediate focus today, if you're looking for immediate action, is whether we close, excuse me, whether we close above or below 1726/32, with the long buy certainly at risk near term while below this zone. All right, again, a breach higher, you're looking for the upper parallel. Right now, that comes in right around 1755, I noted yesterday. And then 2012 highs, 1795. So here's what the daily chart looked like yet earlier in the week. Came right into that support. The high day closed from back here in March. That held on a closed basis, and we're right back at the highs. Here's what it looked like last night on the intraday, and here's what it looks like now. So we just made another run at the high. 2 hour outside reversal candle is in play at this point. Don't want to put too much stock in this. I'd love to see the US Open, see how this looks. But man, it's do or die. It's do or die. Now, you never want to be the trying to be the hero here and try to take a short against this swing high in such a tight market right now. It's just not prudent. But yes, I am looking for exhaustion like basically here. Okay, if this spikes up into that parallel and it closes an hour or 2 hour candle specifically below that, that'd be a great start. Point is, it's all about this zone. A pivot break above this, okay, you're looking for that slope again, 1755s or so would be where the initial slope comes into that daily chart. 2012 highs right there at 1795. Initial support, I would put right here near 1678. It's really 1675 is going to be the weekly open, is right here, right? Or excuse me, 1680s. 1678 is going to be the March high day close. But really, the objective weekly opening range low that converges on upslope support. That's 1659. That's your new bullish inval. So if we break below just the objective weekly lows, this upslope, that would put the short play back in focus, targeting 1633 and 1580s. So a close below 1728, can we take short against 1732? I wouldn't take it against 1732. I'd take it against the high that it registers for the day. You know what I mean? Rizwan, don't be too meticulous. I'm all about tight stops, man. You're talking to a near-term trader, right? But you have to a lot when you're looking at a market like this, you're trying to trade counter trend, which is Rizwan, what we're doing here, right? Any short on gold is counter trend. I don't think anyone's gonna argue with me. But it's important to note these critical levels. So if it spikes higher, ideally you get like a test or a failure of this high, then it closes below. Those are really beautiful, in my opinion. Exhaustion trades. So don't just take a static stop against the high or against this level, take it against the high, right? Couple pips about whatever the high registers at. And then that's how you would play the exhaustion. Does that make sense? Sarub, silver, please. Yeah, I got you. Let's take a quick look. I think you were asking about this before, right? You got me looking at silver. I didn't check the intraday charts this week. I did take a gander at it earlier, but I don't really see much here, by way of formation or, I guess, technical clarity for that matter. Here's the daily chart that we were looking at, right? Noting that momentum on, I think the last time we were talking about this, we noted that momentum was heading right into 60. You had that lateral level right here that we've been following from the lows you made in November of 2016. Really nice pivot in price. I think for silver, were we not looking at the weekly? Yeah, here's the weekly chart. The same level. Saraba, excuse me. Do you remember last week we were, when you asked about this earlier in the week, I told you the only focus is 1469, 1564, you're still in that zone. You're still in that zone. That's just not a random zone. It's not just random fibs. I'm looking at the 38.2. I'm looking at downslope support. And then here we're looking at the objective yearly open and the 50 of the yearly range. All that is right here. Let me clear up some of these extraneous slopes for you. My point being, there's nowhere near the amount of technical clarity here as I do think you have in gold. Now, it's the same, my objective bias on this would be the same, Saurabh. Like, I do think you should be constructive on the broader term. Near term, could this fake out and drop to another low before you resume? Yeah. Is there technical clarity on the daily and intraday charts? My humble opinion, not so much. There's just not much merit to it. I still would expect to see more of a drop lower and then kind of the kickback for the resumption. I would be, let me just say this, Sirab, I'd be surprised if this thing just launches through and goes to a new high. And if anything, some local near-term objective levels I always like to look at on these rallies are, all right, here's the high day close. We registered a high on that day for the month. There's actually a multi-week high. We closed at 1575. You're able to beat that on a closed basis. Resumption. Not. I'd still look for a deeper correction first. Does that help? All right. So that's a quick look at silver on the fringe. He says, yes, thanks. Hey, more than welcome. Saurabh, and keep asking, man. I have no problem looking at these assets. I just don't want to encourage people to actively get involved and operate on these setups if the levels and the conviction just isn't there. So I'm always down to take a look. That is one, two, three, four, and five. SPX, Chip, Pete, Peter. Oh, here's what we're looking at. Today's the day where we need to see something happen near 28, 26. Here's SPX first on the weekly charts. I think I provided you with the whole suite earlier. Remember, on the weekly, we look at this from a log standpoint to give us more of a percentage base. But look, here's the low week reversal close from back here in June of last year. It was a nice pivot in price. The break saw the acceleration that took us into the yearly low. We stopped and closed there last week. Here's this week's drop in recovery. Weekly chart highlights 29.32 is the 6.8 of the yearly range. As far as support's concerned, there's the slope for the downslope we've been following off the yearly high, 38.2. Just the 38.2, this entire rally still looks at 26.20. So is this uptrend resistance? We should be looking for failure. Or is this an opportunity to get back long and punch through? Not my favorite scenario. Here's SPX on the daily. Now, you remember back on that advance that we were making last week, the huge level. I would have loved to see a touch. We didn't quite get the touch, but I don't want to be too meticulous here. 28.95 is the 100% extension from the advance off the low. 29.32 is the 6.8 retracement from the advance off the high. Such a beautiful zone. We registered a high literally like 5 points below that. What was the high? Now I'm curious. 28.90, literally 5 points lower. Turn. Break of upslope support. Could this go higher from here and spike back into this region of fail? Possible. Anything's possible. But look at the momentum profile. Remember what we like to see in our typical momentum profile overlay. So you look at upslope, support at 40, support at 50, multiple breaks into overbought. This is your first break into oversold since the lows that we made there last year. On the rally, if there is still downside to go, 60 should hold resistance. Well, here's 60. My point being, guys, that we're not out of the woods yet. Okay. You could see some failure. You could see some upside still. Wouldn't be surprised, but I'm more on the lot of the mindset that you look to fade that. Here's the intraday chart and the scalp we've been following for the last 2 weeks. Okay, this is the 2 hour chart. Here's what it looked like last night. Here's where we are now. Right? So we were looking for failure ahead of 28, 26, still looking for that. And now you're coming up on slope, right? So you might not get that 618 tap, but that's still the lateral level you want to focus on. Any failure beyond here, your downside targets are well defined. A breach above this, you do have free rein between 2860 and 2894. Again, that level that we should have tagged last week that we just missed might be on tap again. Okay, so for me, it's all about the reaction, the pivot we get off this region here today. If we get pump and failure, I'd be looking to short against the high, looking for resumption. If it breaches, the 2826 level should fuel acceleration, in which case you're again one more time looking for that keys or resistance zone just higher. Questions? Short failure and retest of 2826. I mean, that would be the ideal scenario. My humble opinion, right? Let's take a step back, guys. We have to go with what price is saying. Here's the previous update. Again, don't take my word for anything. Look how we've been performing. We opened up the week saying it failed just ahead of that key resistance zone. We're now at support at 2723. And I even told you we're even a possible fake out resumption rally here. Tread lightly. That was the low. We rallied from there right back higher. It's exactly what happened. This is where you want to start to curb the appetite again. If we're still going to hold this formation, if we're still going to move lower in SPX, 2826 has got to be the level to look for. Now, you'll hear a lot of people today, guys. Rizwan says, thanks. It did, sir. Right. Great. Rally. Yeah. Cheers, Rizwan. Again, it's the market's levels, man. I'm just helping you find them. But, you'll hear all the headlines today start talking about stimulus phase three came through. Markets have will take solace in that there is increased funding, especially for small business. Guys, I don't want to repeat my conversation that I have had with you guys over the last couple of weeks, but the demand destruction is still paramount in my mind. I know a lot of anecdotal, maybe anecdotal on my part, but a lot of anecdotal, real hand accounts of people, business owners and associates and colleagues of mine in the city who have either lost jobs or they're closing or they're laying off their workers despite all this federal aid. If you're a restaurant owner, right, and you're in the city, Manhattan, largest restaurant place in the world, right? Okay, the government's going to pay you to recoup your employees and recoup your lost wages. If you show them that you have maintained your stuff, you get to keep that as a grant. Even when you do reopen, are you going to reopen at full capacity? If you have 100 tables, you're going to be serving 100 tables. You're probably going to be serving 50, if not 30, right? Foot traffic won't be there. It's going to be hard to get people just to snap out of this whole isolation type of thing. The demand destruction that I was talking about the last couple of weeks will start to come to the forefront. So I'm of the mindset that you can, these short-term stimulus news rallies, the real-term impact of the economy, in my humble opinion, still is yet to be seen. And, I just don't think one of those news events are going to be what fuel some sort of massive just recovery to the norm. Yes, the markets are taking solace in that things are getting done, in that there is actually movement on Capitol Hill to address and help the financial situation. But from a liquidity standpoint, it's a big help. From a demand standpoint, man, it's really hard to see this thing snapping back in a V type of deal. Anyway, that's my segue. Sorry to kind of trail off there in that conversation, but with when we're looking at the SPX and specifically on the back of this rally, that kind of comes to the forefront with everything that's going on. All the headlines you guys are going to see today, make sure you're focused on price. Any questions on SPX? So Rob, was it you also who was asking about the Dow last week? Someone was asking about that. Here's what that looks like. We did throw something together. I just want to highlight those levels. He says, yes. Hey man, this is looking just as clean. Okay. Here's the upslope that we were following in Dow last week. There's the break. I tacked on this pitchfork, I think, yesterday. It might have been Tuesday, but long story short, the lower parallel held. Here's the median line. Here's key resistance, 618 of the rally, or the decline rather, on the 75% parallel. So even if you spike higher today, that's the level to look for possible failure. It's not as clear to me because the lateral levels don't really come in anywhere near slope until like later on. But on a move lower, look for that slope, obviously, is going to be a variable on time, but a basic 38.2. It's still, oops, sorry about that. Let me fix that. A basic 38.2 still comes down to 22, right? 22,000, which is a long way from where we are right now. So just to put things in perspective. So that's Dow. Real quick look at the SPX and Dow. That's five and six. Sterling, who's trading British pound? So the trade here also has been very clean. This descending channel formation, looking for a possible breakout if we're going to get resumption. And that would happen basically right here. Here's what Sterling looked like. Yesterday, or I guess this is on the 21st. Here's what it looks like. Here's what it looks like now. So we noted the break of upslope support early in the week. It was just kind of a slow dribble. That was a big level that we were looking at. Broke, basic channel support held. Near-term resistance we cited at 618 with bearish inbound the post-Brexit low week close. That's still the same levels, only basically upper channel got tested as well. So look. I'm so tempted. In the last couple of days, I've been tempted to do a lot on Sterling, both play a little bit of a rebound here, which didn't last very long, but mostly here looking for some sort of tell. You guys know longer term, I've been a big fan of Sterling strength. Obviously, on the reversal here, we were looking for playing the lower parallel. That was our downside play. This is a little bit deeper than expected, but we're still in descending channel formation. So don't get cute on this, is my point. Next downside target, the ideal scenario for you to find an exhaustion low is like 2174, 2195, just below the 22 handle. You have the October low, okay, from back here. You have a basic 38.2 of the advance right here. You have the median line, longer term, you'll see it on the daily chart in a moment, but you also have basic channel support. So if it makes the move lower, that's the zone I want to fade against. From here, if we breach this zone, okay, if we breach this channel, just look for pivot back above 2433. It would sort of put me back in the constructive zone. So real cautious on this one. I was looking at it at a much closer time frame as we were looking at, as I was kind of preparing for this morning. Downside break from here, look for a resumption, topside breach of this consolidation. 2430 is the tell. It's tight, but over the last 48 nights, 24 hours, you've just been in consolidation. Higher highs, lower high, or higher lows, lower highs. I'm looking for a resolution here today. I want to short at 2410, and you're looking for a move towards what? And what do you have at 2485? Let me ask you that, Rizwan. He's looking for a tag of 2195. That's the zone I'm looking for. I think that's sort of the, Here's the thing, when the market's correct, right, and you see a break of uptrend support, you want to see the pivot low register at an important level, right? Both laterally and in slope. This doesn't really do it for me. You know what I'm saying? I'd be hard to press to think that that's the low and we're kind of going to find a resumption. So yeah, I'm more inclined to look for a reaction towards 2195 on Sterling if we get it. And here's the daily chart. Everything's right here for you guys. Right? So even if this recovers, here's the first leg lower, right? Even if this recovers, look at this massive level of importance. I didn't even add on there. Post-Brexit low week closed at 2433. You also have the objective monthly open, right? Right there. The open comes in at 2427. So yeah, it's an important pivot, absolutely. And there's 2195, right? On slope for the broader formation we've been following from the highs. This is the April 2018 high. So Sterling, not quite as ugly as Euro is at the moment, but you're coming into a really nice sort of squeeze here. Look for a reaction today. All right, we are running towards the end here. Let me just pick up the pace a little bit. Kiwi, Aussie, and Swissy. Here's Kiwi. Beautiful trade to the downside early in the week. You guys remember, as we were opening the week right here, we were looking for exhaustion off one of these two levels. You got the top of them. Really nice move. We broke into the April open low, 2006 low at 92, 59.28. Looked like it was going to break, but it held, right? And here's the rebound. So right now, all things held constant, guys, we are poised to post an outside day reversal off of support. That's typically constructive. That being said, key zone of resistance is going to be 60.50. It's the 618 of the recent drop. In fact, I need to adjust that. Excuse me for the new low we made last night. That's 60.46, drops at another 10 pips. But it's the 618, the entire drop, and down slope resistance, same exact slope we turned off early in the week. That's your breakout. So I know, you know, you see an outside weekly reversal, I'm automatically inclined to start to look for the opposite counter trend trade. I wouldn't do that until you clear 60.46. That's the level to beat. Weekly open resistance is right here at 60.28, but the level to beat 60.46. Let's call it 60.50. That would be the breakout. Otherwise, you're still risking 58.70. 100, two equal legs off the low would just give you just 58.70. A 38.2 to the advance is 58.77. You can scratch that for now. For all intents and purposes, I always love to take a step back if I'm getting really excited or near-term price action is kind of playing tricks on me. Kiwi, on a weekly basis, guys, is set for a doji at this point, right? Despite the huge range we saw, look at the range on the weekly. Range highs caught slope resistance, range lows caught lateral resistance and slope resistance, and you're trading just pips off where you opened the week. I'm zoomed in here. You know, this is a really thin weekly candle. So all things held constant, guys. Your range is really, really well defined. 60.46 is the defining resistance here. What is meant by two equal legs? So that means the decline is consistent of lateral legs that are this measurement here. Let me just do this for you in a quick, sort of easy to see. This measurement here is the same as this measurement here, right? So first leg, you get a bounce higher, and then that second leg is the same length of the first leg down. These equal two-leg patterns, Rizwan, can oftentimes be correction. So anyone here harkens back to Elliott theory, you know, your motive waves are five waves, your correction waves are three waves. So if this bounce is just a pullback within the ascent, then two equal legs down should cap the decline. That's still 58.70. He says, thanks. I'm more than welcome, Rizwan. If you have more questions, by the way, encourage you to see to pop into Jamie's webinar tomorrow. He's way bigger on Elliott than I am. But Kiwi has been on the radar and remains. All right, quick look at Aussie. Sideways move there. Looking for Aussie. Still within the confines of the weekly opening range, but it broke that slope we were looking at. So here's what Aussie looked like last time we covered it here. Boom. We were just at the very start of this pitchfork formation. You know, we want to stay bearish below 63.75, looking for targets at 63.14, 62.64, key support at that 100, right? You made these two, but the range lows from last week held, okay? You rebounded back higher. If this is a break of the downslope, this is gonna be your tell. 6.8 of the decline. We pop higher above this, critical resistance is still in play. Remember, the whole reason we turned bearish in Aussie was because of this key resistance zone. Again, I'll bring your attention to the 618 extension of the descent off the lows, 618 retracement of the decline off the December high. It's exactly where this thing found some resistance in jackknife lower. We were looking for support here, right? Didn't quite get it. So while the breakout of near-term downtrend looks good, I caution anything until we break through this, right? This is sort of still the zone that could be a big thorn in our side. Again, broadly speaking, I do like the long side of Aussie, but while below 64 or 45, I just can't get excited about it. Questions? Okay, so heading into Thursday, essentially your Monday, Tuesday stretch is basically still intact, key resistance. And I still think, again, the risk, well, just to highlight it, the risk below 6420, 6450, or the risk is still lower while below that key region of resistance. All right, last but not least, Swissy with a breakout here. Looking for 97.87, this possible choke point. It's 100% off the low. So Rizwan, this is another example. If this recovery is just a correction within the broader downtrend, that's sort of the region of resistance I'd want to see hold. You know, there is some slope there that you could work with, but broadly speaking, whoops. Broadly speaking, we're looking for sort of a exhaustion high type of resistance play, just a little bit higher. So it fits the theme with a lot of these setups, guys, where you think that you got one more stretch before you try to fight what seemingly is a weekly trend. Sir, what is 100%? Sorry for the silly question. No, Rizwan, no problem. The 100% is the exact conversation we were just having. So this is 100% extension means two equal legs off the low. That's all it means, that this would be a 100 measurement of this initial leg up. Rizwan, there's a whole educational tab that goes through a lot of more kind of redundancy of what we cover here, how we break these things down. So if these concepts are a little bit new to you, definitely recommend take a time just to go through those things to familiarize yourself with them. But feel free to throw out these questions. Good questions. So that's Swissy. Any questions on any of the setups right from the website, Rizwan? Resources, right? So there's some whole, the scalp overview, opening ranges of what I do a little bit more in a breakdown type of play. You also have a webinar here that we go through all that. Rizwan, if you follow me on Daily FX, I have a series called The Foundations of Technical Analysis, a whole series. And I will send you that link, actually, just to help you out on that front. But any other questions or trade setups you guys want to review, feel free to throw them on the message board now. here's that link for anyone in the room, by the way, if you need more educational analysis on anything that we're covering here. More than welcome, Rizwan. Always a pleasure, sir. So that's all I have on my end. No other questions. We'll go ahead and wrap things up here. Guys, watch for the fake out pump. I really want to see what happens in SPX today. I think this is going to be really telling. Best of luck trading. There's really not much data or economic data into the close of the week. So we'll pick things up back on Monday in the free session right here on Tuesday and Thursday on SB. Best of luck trading for the rest of the week, guys, and have an awesome, safe, and blessed weekend. Cheers.